I live out of Palos, Bush Gardens. We are here today to witness the marriage of Dillon Ray Overture and Christina Urban. For those of you who don't know me, my name is John Adebeck. I have known the Urbans since Christina was 10, when our family first moved down to Orange County. We would spend Thanksgivings together. Her dad and I would play music together. She would make fun of me for being the world's worst babysitter, usually looking at myself. I never had a sister, but the Urban girls were the closest thing that I did have. They mean a lot to me personally. Dillon and I met more recently when Christina first introduced him to me. I thought to myself, uh-oh, this guy's tall and handsome, I think he got a boyfriend. who am I kidding? I wasn't worried at all. Those of you who know Christina know that she is mature well beyond her years. She's a good judge of people and knows what she wants. When she's determined, that's it. And when I got to know Dillon at family dinners, playing beer pong with him, and then later with his parents, I knew Dillon was not only deserving of our esteem, but a smart, charming, determined young man in his own right that more than holds up his end of the bargain in this relationship. When they asked me to officiate their wedding, I was both honored and excited, very honored that they would allow me to share in this their special day. Weddings are great, aren't they? You eat some food, party like there's no tomorrow. Today you set everything else aside. You might be having the worst day of your life. Today it doesn't matter. You might be having the best day of your life. Again, it doesn't matter. Today is about them and nobody else. Speaking of which, I want to briefly discuss weddings. For those of you who don't know, Dillon and Christina first met in Italian class at UCLA. Dillon was, to quote Christina, the cute guy sitting in the front of the class who riding on a skateboard with his guitar slung across his back. She thought he was so cool. As for Dillon, he thought Christina was the prettiest girl he had ever seen, and he told her that. Again, what a charmer. An interesting thing happened while they were going out. At some point while they were on a date, it came out that neither of them had ever been broken. I know, an odd thing to talk about during the date, but apparently that's when they first realized this was it. Love. Or that someone was going to have an unfortunate first experience with a wrong end of a breakup, but fortunately we know how that turned out, so it's... I want to discuss commitment and sharing with you. As a married couple, they're making a commitment. A commitment to share with one another. Possessions, what's mine is yours, and what's yours is mine. Experiences, from the great to the mundane. Owning a home, maybe some travel, maybe some cooking, some cleaning, grown-up stuff. Fortune, you take the good with the bad. When it's bad or hard, you help each other through. In sickness, in health, for rich or for poor. When it's good, having someone to share with. Someone to encourage, somebody to celebrate with what's really good. And, with luck, they will share something. They will combine all of experience, responsibility, sometimes hardship, but mostly great joy. Of course, I'm talking about children. As a married couple, we will also share with them, and them with us. We are clearly special, and that's what the wedding invitation means. They wanted you here to share their joy with you, and to witness their commitment to one another. And we, in turn, will return the favor to them. We will share our joy in witnessing their union. When they have a second to breathe between taking photographs and saying hi to people, let them know. Come up. Let them know how happy you are to see them there. Raise a glass to them. Or raise several glasses. Maybe not too many glasses. We don't need the guests becoming the center of attention. Again, today is about them. Of course, the best way you can share your joy with them is when the ties and the shoes come off and they get up on the dance floor to dance, you get up there and dance with them. Dance hard. Show them you really mean it. And when you start feeling tired or feeling like you may want to sneak out early, remember, today is not about you. It's about them. Now, why do we do all this? Showers, ceremonies, receptions. mean, besides the fact that the weather is nice and the horse is a manifestation of their union and our commitment. Them to each other, them to us, and us to them. This is their first time stepping up and being Mr. and Mrs. Overton. As one, a team. An island in our archipelago. And their island is a hot place to be. It's the five-star resort having its grand opening in New Orleans. And when I say us or our, who do I refer to? I mean our community. Those of us who know and love and support Dillon and Christina. Family and friends. They separately were part of our community. Now, here today, we are re-inducting them into our community as a whole. A new, united Mr. and Mrs. Overton. By doing so, we make a commitment to love and support them. And one day, maybe their island will expand. And we will accept their expanded island in our community as well. Of course, I am again talking about children. No pressure. Within a community, people have different ways of expressing this love and community to one another in different ways. Different traditions that we share with one another. With that said, we have some family members here who wish to share their traditions with you. First, Mrs. Quinda Urban, Christina's mother, will perform a reading from the Torah, or as it is. And second, Mrs. Carolyn Lawton, Dillon's grandmother, will perform a reading from the New Testament. So, Mrs. Urban, please come up.
Devotion, love devotions, and life with the King. expression of who God is. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, who have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers to understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, I have not love. If I give away all I have and deliver up my body to the burn, and I have not love, I gain love. Love is patience and kindness. Love is no envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. Does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoings, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never ends. Three things will last forever. Faith, open love.
Dillon and Christina have written their own vows, which they would like to share with you. I've done enough talking, so I'll leave it up to them. Dillon, if you'd like to start. The first time I met you, I always smiled. You got it. Just everything else about you made me want to know you better. I'm so glad that they took a chance to show it 4 years ago. I haven't looked back once. You're the sweetest, most caring, bravest, kindest, most remembered person I know. You picked up everything and moved to the last of it. And I love you so much. You're sweet. I vow to be open and honest. No matter what the time or the situation, I vow to love you every day as much as I love you. I vow to have patience.
Thank you.
Joanne, may these rings serve as a symbol of your affection. Dillon, in placing this ring on Christina's hand, please repeat after me. With this ring, I be willing.
With this ring, I be willing.
And with all that I am, all that I have.
With all that I am.
Placing this ring in Dillon's hand. This ring. I do. With all that I am and all that I have.
With all that I am and all that I have.
I honor. Just as these rings have broken into wings, may your union be strong and blessed for your life as you journey through life together surrounded by a circle. Now, Dillon, you take Christina to be your lawful wedded wife to have and to hold forever. By the power vested in me by the state of California as a deputy commissioner of civil marriages, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Congratulations, and you may now kiss the bride.